When you look at a map of poverty, of housing instability, of the murders that have taken place over the course of time, it's all concentrated in the northwest corner of Louisville, the west end of Louisville. And in the city of Louisville, we have a housing crisis. 31,412 units for households at the lowest level of income are needed. So when you can't afford to live here in the neighborhood with the highest rate of poverty, highest percentage of renters, if you can't afford to live here, you can't afford to live anywhere. And to a certain extent, you could argue you're not supposed to afford to live at all. When you get pushed out of neighborhoods like Russell, when you get pushed out of the west end of Louisville, when you get pushed out of this area, you really got three options. You could be houseless in a junkyard, you can be imprisoned in a prison yard, or you'll be dead in a graveyard. We get pacified and we get symbolic gestures such as honorary street signs and murals, but we don't necessarily get any sort of improvement when it comes to our conditions when you look at our economic conditions, and that's what we need. I'm working on avoiding the institution of policing altogether, being proactive about fixing your conditions in this area, in this neighborhood, in your community, so you don't have to come into contact with the police. Because as long as we stand in Russell, that has the highest percentage of poverty, you are going to have the highest percentages of crime. Thus, you're going to call who, whenever those crimes are committed? You're going to call the police. And they react to crime. They don't prevent crime. The crime already occurred, and then they show up. And in some cases, they escalate those situations. So I'm less worried about the police and more worried about addressing poverty, which is the root cause of all interactions with the police to begin with.